in your 20s, if you have a lot of money or if you don't have a lot of money, no matter the situation, you should be asking these questions. You should be going through this process of studying and finding people who did figure it out, who have figured it out, or who have made mistakes, and what can you do differently in order to set yourself up, to set your family up, to set the people around you up for success when you're older in life. Because one of the points that we're gonna get to is talent goes away. Like, Brandon's ability to be a phenomenal business person will eventually go away. When he's 85 years old, my guess is you're not gonna wanna be showing up to meetings and building businesses in the same way that you do now. And you are setting your life up to be able to do that with
passive
income.
Even if I want to do that, it doesn't set up everyone else I love in my family.
Because as soon as he dies, everything would go away. It would all be key man dependent. If Brandon was spending all the money that he was getting.
And what'd Grant call that money?
Stupid money?
No. If you if you're required to show up in first money?
Oh yeah, first money. Income money.
Yeah, so first money. It's like you got to do something to get it.
Yeah, you have to be in a space at a certain amount of time for a certain amount of time in order to get paid. Whether it's a speaking engagement, whether it's your 9-to-5
or your
job.
You're a musician,
you have to show up and you have to be recording something. Like, for the money that you make when you show up for something, you should never ever spend that money. The money that you should spend and that you should be living off of is the second money. So the money that either makes money off of that first money. So if you're investing in real estate, you're investing in the stock market, whatever your investments are, or if you have a second flow of income that is established after you've created your first money or your primary income.
Yeah, and to be clear, Grant doesn't, the stock market doesn't give you that, right? It's too volatile and it's not dependable and it doesn't create income.
I was gonna get there, but some people have their investments in.
No, I know, so I got there before you did. So what he's saying is your second money should produce the income.
Yes.
So it has to be something that generates income. Your second money should generate the income that you can live passively on. Your first money should be to fuel the second money, right? And that's the mistake. And in particular, he asked this guy a question. He said, do you want to be 70 and still having to go to all the different places and hotels and casinos?
The Hard Rock. Do you want to be performing when you're 70 years old because you have to show up to make money at the Hard Rock?
Because you never created
because
second
your talent,
money.
And your talent will run out. It will happen. Your pizzazz, whatever it is, you will die. Even if you're talented until you die and still showing up and people are paying you to exchange some service, you still, with the money that you have made, you can still multiply it so you don't have to continue to show up. You don't have to put yourself in that position. You don't work a 9-to-5 every day. Grant doesn't work a 9-to-5 every day because you've moved past being able to have to do that.
Yeah.
You make a lot of money from when you do show up, but you also have passive income. And so the point with people who are young here is when you first find yourself getting into even a little bit of money, you find your first $5,000, you're into, maybe you get a tax return for $1,000, like, start thinking about not spending that money.
And not saving it, not putting it in a savings account.
That was my other thing, another big takeaway is you don't save it. Think of your mindset as preparing that money to use. So never say, oh, I'm saving this money. You're preparing to use it and deploy it in a way where it will make money for you. Don't save money. Saving money and thinking that you're gonna be able to have enough, store up enough, it will never be enough if you're not confident in your ability to put it in things that will allow it to multiply, that will allow it to grow.
That's right.
It's like, I know people in their 50s, 60s, 70s think about this stuff because there's time there. But young people, I never have
this conversation
with people.
We know a lot of people that are in their 60s and 70s that still think, I need to just work another 3-to-5 years because I don't actually have enough money stored up.